Hey everybody, it's Ms. Barnacle again. Now we're going to talk about turning fractions into percents. When you take a fraction and turn it into a percent, it's like the opposite of turning a percent to a fraction. Instead of taking the number and turning it and putting it over 100, what we're going to do is two things. One, we're going to use example A, 3 over 4, to show you how to set up a proportion for that one. And then B, I'm going to show you how to turn a fraction into a decimal, and then from the decimal, turn that into a percent. So let's go to the board and I'll show you these two methods. Okay, so the first one, 3/4, I'm going to set this equal to 100 because remember, percents are always out of 100. And we don't know what 3/4 would be as a percent out of 100. So that we're going to use cross products. In one of the previous modules, I showed you how to do this. Now, why am I doing it this way for this particular one? And the reason why is because 4 divides into 100 an even number of times. If you have that, you know, scenario where you can divide the first fraction into the 100 an even number of times, this is the fastest way to get your answer. So you're going to do cross products. This would be 3 times 100 is equal to 4 times n. So 3 times 100 is 300. And that's equal to 4n. So again, you want to find out the n. And in order to do that, you get rid of the number attached to the variable by doing division, because you do the opposite. So that gives you n. And that's equal to 300 divided by 4. 4 divides into 37 times, and that leaves a remainder of 2. We bring down the next number, and that's 20. So 4 divides into 25 times, and that leaves me 75. So n is 75, and what are we looking for? Percent. So 3/4 is 75%. That's how you do that. Now, what happens if you know that your fraction does not divide into 100 an even number of times? Okay, 1/8. 8 does not divide into 100 an even number of times. So obviously I can't use that method. So I'm going to use a different method. The basic, take the bottom number, divide it into the top, make it into a decimal first, okay? Now I'm just doing division like we did in, I don't know, a module 2 or 3 times ago. And when I do this, 8 does not divide into 1, so I put the 0. 8 does divide into 10. It goes in there one time, which makes 8. That leaves me 2. Bring down the 0. 8 divides into 20, 2 times, which makes 16. Subtract and I get 4. Bring down the next 0. I already added 3 zeros because I knew this was going to come out even. But if you don't know that it's going to come out even, then you just keep adding zeros until it either comes out even or you notice the pattern and you can cut it off. So 8 divides into 40 5 times, which is exactly 40. And I get the decimal 0.125, which is 125 thousandths. Now, once you have your decimal, okay, I'm almost home. I have one step left to do. So I'm going to take my decimal, and to turn a decimal into a percent, we did that on a previous module one or two ago. All you had to do was take the decimal point, move it 2 places to the right, and there you have it. It is 12.5 or 12.5%. So there are your two options to turn percents to decimals, or turn fractions, into percents. You can either do cross products if you have something that's divisible into 100, or you can just do the basic, divide it, and then move the decimal 2 places. All right, that's all we have to say for that lesson. I will come back with another one shortly.